think something new under the sun. You can't take back them things you already done. No. You blame things that you do on somebody else. No. What they all see is you need help.
My name's Craig Grimes. I'm the managing director and founder of Experience Community, which is a not-for-profit organisation that helps disabled people access green space in the countryside. So from a very selfish perspective, I set up Experience Community because I wanted to get out into the countryside. There wasn't any information out there. And I know from my personal perspective, being in environments like this, where you've got the birds, you've got the rustle of the leaves and the breeze. It's just a relaxing environment. It's great for your mental health, but also because you're pushing these bits of kit, it's good for physical exercise as well. Back in the mid-90s, I was a non-disabled person. I was going about my studies like everybody else. I was doing a degree in geography and environmental science, and my plan was to go off and do a bit of volunteering in the Czech Republic, studying otters, and then do a master's in national park management at Aberystwyth University. Unfortunately, in my final year, I had an accident. I became paraplegic. And back then, there wasn't any access to the countryside, really. It was just starting to become an item on the agenda. And I went to an Access the Countryside conference with the Open Recreation Network. And somebody there from Natural England asked me about how I would describe footpaths for disabled people. And I said, well, I wouldn't. I'd make films about them, and I'd show people what they were going out to and what the surfaces are like and what the barriers are like, what the gradients are like, so that they can make informed, independent decisions as to whether they wanted to tackle a route or not. When we talk about providing disabled access to the countryside, sometimes people think that we're talking about sanitizing the green space. But like everybody else, disabled people want to come out and enjoy the natural beauty of our surroundings. So it can be about small changes. It can be about replacing a step stile when it's falling down for a 4-foot wide gate, so that bits of kit like this that are quite wide can actually get through them. When we're resurfacing a bridle way that's been washed out, it's about getting rid of the bigger lumps and bumps so that we give more access to more people. We're not talking about tarmacking everything. We're talking about tweaks to make the environment more inclusive for more people. In 2014, we got some funding from Kirklees Council, and that enabled me to employ a member of staff and for us to start actually getting people out into the countryside. We started by doing short wheelchair walks at Dewsbury Country Park and walks along the Huddersfield Broad Canal. Canals are really important to us as disabled people because they provide opportunities to access decent towpaths. So it's really important that we find a balance between access and heritage in all of our landscapes, so that we preserve and conserve what's important to us while allowing everyone to enjoy them. We got involved in the South Pennine Walk and Ride Festival, and I had one of these bits of kit, a mountain trike. And we started looking at getting people out, trying these, and mountain trike came along and showed them to a few people. And on that first event, we realized that people were discussing where to take them, how to maintain them, and how to ride them. And so we realized there was an opportunity to fundraise for more of these bits of kit and help more people get out into the countryside.
So from our base in Leeds, we've got bikes that people can come and try. So they might have an idea of the kind of bike that they'd like to try, and when they actually come and try it, it's not particularly right for them, it's not suitable for their needs. So we've got a different range of equipment that people can come and try. So we get people out in, around the bike park in Leeds, build up their confidence a little bit, and then hopefully we'll encourage them to come out and do more challenging routes.
So this particular one is, so this one's called an ice trike. This has also got a motor on it, so that if you want a little bit of a boost as you're riding around, this one is for guys and girls that can have still got some leg movement. So in this one, we've got what we call a mountain trike, and it's pretty much like a beefed up wheelchair in terms of when you see it, but it's designed to take you sort of off-road, hand-powered. So basically this works on a sort of lever system, and you're literally just using upper body strength to move that, propel that forward. This particular one has also got a motor, and again, just to give that additional support.
Generally, the components have come from the biking industry. It's just the same equipment used in a completely different way. So instead of having your rear derailleur at the rear, our drive wheel's at the front. The rear derailleur is in the same position, but it's upside down. And we tend to use things like two chain lengths rather than just the one. So they're fun. They can be fickle beasts, but generally they're the same as a regular bike.
So that particular piece of kit will clamp onto someone's wheelchair. Now this one again, it's got a motor on it, but as you can see from that one, you're hand cranking.
I'm Jack Schofield, and I've been coming to Experience Community for about a year and a half now, and tried every piece of kit going. First time, I'm gonna be honest, I was a bit of an idiot. I sort of just went hell for leather. I tried to go on the sort of recumbent hand cycles at first, and they were brilliant. They just fit my needs precisely. But then when I was at home, I got a bit bored, and I was finding myself wanting to go hand cycling, but there's no way I could have possibly carried the hand cycle home or even used it outside of the bike park. So we asked Craig and sort of the crew, and they said, have you tried this attachment for your own wheelchair? And it just clicked onto my wheelchair, and it's a fully functioning hand cycle. Bought the kit straight off, and it's been amazing, brilliant. First day I got it, a friend went on a bicycle ride that they were just gonna go on the Todd, asked if I could join them, and we ended up doing about 50 miles there and back, just on the canal, absolutely blitzing it, and it was like I was able-bodied.
It isn't all about one-off trips into the countryside though. A lot of the equipment that we use can be used in active travel. So it's about having an impact on people's everyday lives. If you've got the right kit, you can leave your car at home. Disabled people are frequently what we call door-to-destination car users. So we have a massive impact on the environment through our carbon outputs. If we provide the right electric assist equipment, people can use walking and cycling urban infrastructure to get about their daily lives.
I'm not allowed to drive a car because of my condition. And this attachment for my wheelchair allows me to get that independence that a car would offer me, but also gives me the safety of I'm not going to crash it and, you know, cause problems for everyone else. And the attachment has just been brilliant. I've gone to the pub, I've gone meeting friends. It's just been incredible.
My name's David, I'm 55, been in a wheelchair 16 years now, 2005. I actually had a mountain bike accident on Friday the 13th, it was, so I'm not superstitious at all now. Well, I've always been like an active person, so before my accident, mountain biking, swimming, running, football. It did take a couple of years just to get used to sort of living again. I started going down to the gym, started swimming again, but I've never really been a gym person. I've always been like an outdoors person, really. And then I was first introduced to something called, have you seen the mountain trikes? Yeah, and the first go on that was an amazing experience, really. Sort of just the freedom, it just gives you freedom. Craig does sort of off-road hand cycling. And then a few years ago, we did some like sportives or whatever on road. So I've now got my own road hand bike. What I like to do is I drive off to nice sort of country lanes or whatever and go for a hand cycle on my own. And I didn't used to do that sort of like 3 or 4 years ago. It gives you a lot more confidence just in your day-to-day sort of living or whatever. So you sort of think, if I can do what I do hand cycling, just everyday living is nothing really.
When I first started volunteering with Natural England in 2010, it was just a little project. And it progressed from there to becoming Experience Community. And never in my wildest dreams did I expect to be starting off as a volunteer to then working with landowners such as Natural England and Natural Resources Wales in a professional way.
So I'm Neil Russell. I work for Experience Community currently as the Yorkshire Water Partnership Officer. So my job with Yorkshire Water is to get people, disabled people out using the path and using the different routes around a lot of the reservoirs, etc., and trying to just increase the kind of number of disabled people out there kind of being able to access this and these kind of environments. So what you find with things like ESS and the developments and the technological developments that are there is it's meaning that you can go further for longer and you can go to tougher terrains, so you can get to see places that you would maybe not normally get to see.
The impact that we've managed to have on individual people's lives has been quite astounding. People getting out to places that they never thought that they'd get back to, working with people and them getting back onto the Solway Firth, onto the beach for the first time in 10, 15 years. It's just an amazing feeling. And for me, myself, being able to get back to places that I never expected to go to, it can be pretty overwhelming at times.